Many managers that I'm speaking with, they are starting to be concerned about the career with the continued working from home. Because when you're not having this physical presence with your managers, with your peers, are you sure you will be evaluated correctly? Are you sure that your career is still on track with everything being from home and remotely? Welcome back. I'm Frederik. Now, I've been spending most of my life rebuilding businesses, growing businesses, restructuring, changing organizations, doing transformation. And you can only do this through and with people. So I've been working with people in teams, motivation, team spirit, all these things, my whole life. Even during the pandemic, I was managing a merger between two companies successfully. Completely virtual. And right now, I'm doing something similar, almost again, completely virtual. I therefore think it would be a good idea for me to share with you how I evaluate people, how I judge people, because ultimately, the people that I'm working with as a senior manager, it is my responsibility to coach them, to grow them, to make sure that they are on their career path. One of the things that has happened during the pandemic is that we are having less FaceTime. Yeah, maybe we are turning on our video, but we are still lacking the physical activity, the physical presence. And that means there will be an increased focus on deliverables. It will be more difficult to coach people because you will not see how people are interacting between each other. You will just see typically a round icon of either some initials or a photo. And that cannot help you as a manager to sense how people they are, how they are reacting, how they are interacting with their peers. And this is extremely important when you're looking at how to grow people, how to develop people. You need to know how people they interact with others. And when everything is virtual, this is very, very difficult. That means that the demands on me as a leader is growing because I still have to coach people. I still have to put people on the right career path. So I'm extremely focused on how people interact in the virtual sessions we have. I'm extremely focused on the wordings in emails. And this is right and this is wrong because we are missing this element. And let me tell you one thing. One of the worst things you can do if you want to have a chance to advance, if you want to have a chance to get a good feedback, a good coaching from your leader, that is to not turn on your video. If every time you're talking with the team, every time you're talking with your manager, it's only your picture or your initials, then remember this. We judge people 93% by how they use their hands, how they use their eyes, how they use their facial expression, and only 7% by the words that they use. So if you are decimated to a little icon with a photo of you, then people can only listen to your tone of voice and hear what you're saying. They don't have an idea of if you're joking, if you're serious, if you're accommodating, because they cannot see that from your facial expression. They can only see your icon, so turn on your video. For God's sake, turn on your video. It is one of the most important things you can do if you want your leader to assess you and help you grow even stronger. Another deadly sin, if you like, is the dazing off. We know it all too well, all of us, right? We are checking our emails, we are looking at our WhatsApp or our phone or doing something else, and then all of a sudden you hear your name. What do you think, Frederik? And you go panicking and you're fumbling for the unmute button and you think, yeah, oh, I'm sorry, I was on mute. That's just a bad signal to send because everybody knows that you're doing something else and your leader knows that you're not paying attention. And in many cases, you can also hear it from the reply coming in. So be present when you are online, be present. Do your part to make the meeting shorter if it's difficult to keep focus for that long, but be present. Make sure that you are actively participating in the discussion. Your leaders will notice. You all know this when you're looking at Teams or Zoom and you have 16 people, right? And 5 out of the 16 people, they are talking and the rest are just completely quiet. It is the leader's responsibility to notice this, and they do, trust me. So be active. Be an active listener. Give your aha or give your short acknowledgements that you are listening to what's being said. It also helps the people presenting feel better because they feel that people are actually listening and not just, you know, they're talking to a camera. only. For you as a person, if you want to advance your career in this virtual world, there are some things that you also have to do, in my opinion. You need to make yourself available for your manager. You need to assign some time, 10%, 15% of your day, to socialize with others, to socialize with your manager. You need to be a little more open in what you think and how you speak, because you need to show how you feel to your manager so he or she can help you. So it's up to you to be more open, more available for coaching, for talks with your manager. Be more open and honest. This is so important because that also helps your manager to get to know you better if the relationship between you is just new. Another simple trick is to make sure that you stay on the radar, in the sense that when people are writing mails or chats to you, you are responsive immediately. This makes your name pop up sooner, and it also shows that you are active, that you are engaged. Normally you would be in office. Normally you would be walking around, seeing your colleagues, talking to them, but you cannot do this in a virtual world. The way you can simulate this is to be there immediately when there are chats, when there are emails, and show people that you are actively participating instead of just sending smileys. Add some value, be there, make sure that everybody can feel that you are contributing to the team that you are part of. And then, of course, the last thing that I think is extremely important is to demonstrate that you're structured, to demonstrate that you are delivering, to demonstrate what you're doing. We always see the people in office that are coming at 8 in the morning and leaving at 8 p.m. and we assume that they're very busy. But in a virtual world, we don't see that. We don't see how many hours you're sitting in front of your computer. So it's very difficult to judge what you're actually doing. So in that sense, make sure, without bragging, of course, without overdoing it, but make sure that you make people aware of what you're doing, what you're delivering, and what benefits that is giving the team and your manager and your company. I believe in a virtual world, it is your responsibility also to reach out a little more, especially to your leaders. Reach out and be there. Show people that you are actively participating in everything. Don't turn off your video. Don't just sit on mute for a whole meeting and be present as an icon. If you are participating in a meeting, make sure you are participating in the meeting. I guarantee you, me as an old silver fox, I notice everything. So if you're working with me, I would notice if you're an icon that is quiet. And I would assume all other leaders are doing the same. It is interesting times. It is different times. It is difficult times. I feel one of the most important things for us to move on together is to be more open, to me, more proactively seeking relationship engagements between each other, talk to each other, because we don't have this casual meeting by the coffee machine. This casuality has to be planned now. Make sure that you set aside this 10-15% of your working day to socialize with your colleagues, your peers, and of course your leaders. Get out there. Good luck. Stay safe. Thank you very much for your attention. Bye-bye.